Welcome to Gord Field here in Detroit Rock City, home of the Motor City Maniacs. I see the Maniac fans are trying to get the fire wave going. But so far, just a small number of fires and mostly just on the upper deck.
Yeah, they've really stepped up security, Grim. In the men's room earlier, I only witnessed 3 random assaults and 2 of them were on me. Not bad for game day.
Pain, suffering, humiliation, and possibly a conga line. This game's gonna have it all. The Diami Krakens battle the Motor City Maniacs. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Grim Blitzrow with you, along with my partner, former player Brickhead Mulligan.
Hi.
And his life partner, the mini mutant head that lives on his shoulder, Bricks Jr.
Hey, you just threw up on my shoulder.
I don't often drink beer, but when I do, I get totally shit-faced. I am the world's most intoxicated man.
Say that again. And it's 1st and 10. 4 yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
2nd down and 6.
Sandwiches. I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Yeah, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. 1st and 10. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
1st and 10. Bricks, the offense has been relentless on this drive.
Is the defense wearing green? Because they're doing everything but forcing a stop.
1st and 10. Gets 3 yards on that run. 2nd down and 7. And the quarterback calls a sonic blast dirty trick and throws.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
1st down and 1. And the defense was reading him like a book. He could go all the way. They're gaining on him.
Hey, come on, move your ass. I got a sawbuck riding on this asshole. Second down and more than the QB would like.
sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
Third down and, well, good luck. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
With the vicious kill.
Did you know late hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schlong Galaxy phone.
And it's first and 10. And he punched his way out of that tackle.
Another interception. Geez, you give this guy a bigger paycheck than ever.
He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that.
Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. That Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
Second and 3.
Hot one, hot two.
And the quarterback throws another pick. Oh, with the brutal hit. Well, that's a strange penalty called right there.
I'm starting to notice that this ref likes talking, and it don't make much sense.
No, but he's making a lot of dollars.
First and 10. It's a jailbreak. And the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Oh, crowd's loving it. And it's first and 10. And that's another turnover for the defense. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that jump too fast.
And it's first and 10. Line the way your wife hits the all-you-can-eat buffet of crabapple trees, Bricks.
You're telling me. She ate 47 Salisbury steaks one time. Thought she had food poisoning. Turns out her lower intestines just exploded.
No, that's a relief, because there's nothing worse than food poisoning.
You're telling me.
Oh, he just got crushed. Second down and 10. Right, the QB's gonna have more in it. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and 10. That's about a 3-yard pickup. Second down and 7.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Oh, great play by the defense. The receiver didn't stand a chance. And that'll bring up third down and 7.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB...
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Yeah. First and 10. And another.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And it's first and 10. First and 10.
Hot one.
The fans are looking a bit bored. After a quarter with no score, they're cheering on the refs. At least someone's moving the ball. And it's first and 10.
Hot one. Hot two.
Oh, look at this guy break tackles. And then catch will give them a first down. First and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
I think the defenders are scared of this guy, Bricks, and they have every right to be.
Yeah, he's a murderer!
First and 4. Second down and 6. And into the end zone with a burst of speed.
I think he's more of a downer's guy than a speed freak, Chris. He's running from his dangerous clear.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It's good. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, what a brutal hit! And picks up 7 yards right there. Second and 3. The runner pulls out a chainsaw.
That didn't seem like...
No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. Oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. And it's first and 10. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's...
I know I said never hit a man when he's down. It's just plain lazy. Less extra effort there.
And it's first and 10. I don't know whose eyes the QB is. Oh!
Wow, he took like 1,000 volts of shock there. They did that to my Aunt Lizzie because she thought she was the reincarnation of Lizzie Borden the Ant Smiler.
Did the shock treatment work?
Well, after she killed 4 of the doctors and zapped her, they never bothered her again. So, yeah, I guess it worked for her.
stopped at the line of scrimmage. Second down and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot
three. He might have managed to dig it. Oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. Third down and 8.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Just burning down the house, he's taking it to the house. Boom, and he's dead.
Wow, bingo, 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 I got bingo, bro.
Oh, and he breaks. And that reminds me of the great burning balls of fire costume contest at Burning Man last year. 9 of the 10 guys are on life support now, but now the winner was very lucky. He's now the spokesman for California Raisins. Running back. No rest for the weary. The last runner has to suck it up and hopefully not die. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's 1st and 10. Great run for a 9-yard gain. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. To the races, and he runs out of gas and got tackled short of the goal line. Hell of a run, though.
Lack of stamina happens to a lot of guys, Grim. At least that's what I hear.
And he zips that one in there for a touchdown. And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's 1st and 10. The quarterback has had enough and calls a murder ball dirty trick to lay waste to the defense. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jet, you son of a bitch.
And they stump the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy!
Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection. Second down and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. Third down and the punter is warming up.
Hot two.
Defense gives up 5 yards on that pass play. Smart move there as they call a timeout, trying to get the ball back for another shot. For a kick this far, you just got to kick it as hard as you can, partner.
And aim. It's really important from this distance.
It's probably a smart idea. He's got the distance, and the kick is good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and 10. Down. See if they can get something going here. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grant, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast.
Why would they do that?
He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on MFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
And the offense has only two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last two runners for this outfit.
It's not short, but this one shouldn't give the kicker any trouble.
Unless he collapses under pressure and never makes another kick again.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. The start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? A carnival? Huh? I'm going to go to a striptease show. Where are we going?
Hey, why don't you sell down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
He broke free and has open field in front of him.
Can't keep a good mutant. Somebody get that guy a beer, because he just saved me $1,000.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one.
That ball was almost intercepted. second down and 10. Second down, and the offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down, and ain't gonna happen, partner.
One, hot two.
And another interception. This quarter.
One time when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the line. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can see that, Grim.
And it's first and 10. One in for the... Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot! That's why we love the MFL! The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass.
Yeah, well, at least they don't have to forfeit them.
That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. First down and 3. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown.
Yo, seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
Comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He's gonna be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably crammed his pants.
It's first and 10. Just keep pounding the ball right up the gut and you'll tire these guys out. First down. And it's first and 10. Defense! gets another pick. Man, rough. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Kill.
Did you know late hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schwong Galaxy phone.
And it's first and ten. And he was steering a pick six but dropped the interception.
And it's why he's on defense, schmuck.
Second down and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
He refuses to go, and then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, my gosh! The defensive player looks like he's...
He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. Must be their lucky day. The offense comes up with the ball. The offense is running low on quarterbacks. They have only two left. They might consider running the ball more. Second down and a lot. The defender says, I don't think so. Third down and long. That was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Starting to click now. A pickup of eight on the play. Second down and two. And he just slipped away like a greased pig.
Let me tell you, getting shocked is no joke. I used to wear triple wolf socks, slide around on a shag copper for 8 hours so I could shock my younger brother. I went to change the TV channel.
And the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Grim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
First and ten. And that's the way you play a guy. Nice coverage. Second down and ten. Third and one. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I want John Kicker to make a kick like this with his extra leg.
least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. Ballsy, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter.
Apparently the punter for the day is being played by my kick.
And he just lets that one go. He says, no thank you, and the defense downs it. And it's first and 10. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
Second down in a very lot. Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue.
The teams have kept each other at bay for now, but there's still plenty of time to bribe refs and kill the other team's star player, so it's anyone's game, really, Bricks. Third down and, well, good luck.
He should give this guy a bigger paycheck than everybody else combined.
Holy mother of mutant mayhem, he scored!
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and 10. Rumbling and stumbling, he could go all the way. And it's first and 10. And then catch will give them a first and.
Bingo, bingo, I just hit that mutant bingo. And all I was missing was his number for the last three plays. Talk about luck.
And it's first and 10. And the back gets in there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can swat.
Second down and 10. And with another pick, the QB says his cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. They might catch him.
Oh, you fat little mutant.
First and 8 to go. The quarterback had no time to throw, and the defense gets a big sack. Second down and more than the QB would like. He broke free. Looks like someone uploaded some new dance moves. Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called...
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! Left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
The defense didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. Second down and 10. That's a sack.
Speaking of sacks, has anybody seen my powder? I'm itching like crazy over here.
Third down, and the punter is warming up. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he put all of his foot into that one. They just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. And it's first and 10. Remember, folks, in the MFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback just like that. Second down and a lot. He could go all the way. He's at the 40. And the defense is on his heels. Caught for the first down. First and 10. Should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know. Right now, what day is it?
And it's first and 10. Oh, great throw, great catch, and then put 6 points on the board.
The defense can do anything to stop.
like this, they're going for two. Turn here to set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's first and ten. And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback must have learned a lot about sharing when he was in school.
Yeah.
Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
And it's first and ten. Second down in a very lot. Oh, great pass on that play. They caught the defense napping. Third down and eight. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, the defense is going to have... Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. And it's first and ten. And that's a great 9-yard completion there.
Hey, it ain't great if you don't score or move the chains.
Why are they stopping the clock for the offense, Grim?
They're stopping it for their own offense. They're hungry for the ball, partner.
The ball? The pigskin? Bacon! I'm hungry for bacon!
At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completions. And he breaks away! I'll shoot you in the head.
People like it!
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The kicker's gonna have to kick the ball just right so his team can recover it. And that, ladies and mutants, is how you recover an onside kick. And it's first and ten. Another interception. This quarterback is going to listen to Joy Division and weep tonight. Pow! With the brain scrambler. And it's first and ten. QB know which team he's on?
I don't even know.
And he's off to the races. Here comes the defense. He's at the great shoestring tackle. And the offense offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game. At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw in the towel.
Yeah, he's probably having an intercept.
And like bricks his balls, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Now, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected. Those are pretty much just...
The Maniacs rule today and take home a big win. It was a decisive win. The home crowd is cheering and throwing up at the same time. Too much excitement and booze will do that to you. And the players are celebrating as they search for missing appendages. They left it all on the field today, or most of it anyway.
Oh, you're not kidding. The blood and gut sucking Zamboni is coming out now. Hey, if anyone needs a liver transplant, there's a nice looking one down on the 40-yard line.
And let's hear what the MVP has to say.
Oh, I can't wait to hear what the most valuable prickhead has to say. Blah, 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 you suck. You tanked my fantasy game last week, you douchebag.
Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so...